had ordered more glasses from this company called War by Parker, Warby. Honestly, I have no idea how you pronounce it, but it was like 2 vlogs ago when I showed you guys the ones I ordered. And now I ordered more, but I'm so indecisive. I can't tell if like I like them or not. So if you guys want to let me know, that'd be nice and helpful if you guys think they're cute and whatnot. So the first pair is these right here. And I love that they're clear and they look pretty on. But I just don't like how the lens itself is so small. I would prefer them a little bigger. So I don't know. This is how they look. So they're clear all around and I don't know. I'm like so indecisive, like I said. And then these other ones, I just dropped some. So seem like they're nice, right? But like I think they're a little odd. Like I can't I don't know. So, and then I have another pair. Hold on. Okay. So this. And then I have one more pair, which is this one here. Hold on. And these are like the ones that I already have. They're black. And then here, but the only thing that's different is here is like half of it is clear, as you can see, which I like, but I can't tell, guys. If you guys want to help me out and tell me if they're cute or not. I wanted to show you guys my outfit really, really quick. I look like a ghost, so sorry. But anyways, so I am wearing a chunky knit sweater from Target. So it's pretty tight from like here. And then it gets really loose at the sleeves, which I love. I paired it with some gold jewelry. And then I'm just wearing some black jeans and some black booties. So I am going to get ready right now, and I thought it would be a great idea to vlog it and like you guys get ready with me, and maybe we can talk a little bit. So the first things that I'm gonna do is just moisturize and prime. I just got out the shower, so I am bare. So what I'm gonna use is this guy right here. I just started using it, and if I'm being completely honest, I don't love it. It's a moisturizer, but I use it more to prime my face and moisturize. So at night I won't use this. I'll use my Pond's moisturizer, because I feel like I have very, very dry skin, guys. Here and under my eyes and my eyelids are so dry, so I need something that's really, really gonna moisturize my face, and I don't think this does it for me, and the smell of it is just not my favorite. So, but I am still giving it a shot, and I do like it as a primer because I do notice it does help my makeup stay on just a little longer. So I'm gonna use this today, about that much. Okay, also I don't know if you guys can tell, maybe not, I hope you can, because it wasn't cheap. I'm using a new lens. I went yesterday to Best Buy to buy myself a new lens. So not because my other one wasn't good or anything, the one that I was using before, it just already came with my camera, but I wanted something new. So I watched another vlogger, her name is Alexandra, and I noticed that her camera was showing everything that was behind her, and it was basically like the wide eye effect. And I went to see if my camera can get that lens, and it did, so I got it. So it isn't crazy, like a crazy big difference, but I can tell. So I can personally tell that now like the whole background can show. And before, as soon as I would start recording this, where I have it now, like it would be super close to my face, like crazy close. So I like it a lot better. I also bought a stabilizer for it, so I can put it like on the counters and stuff, something a little smaller. So it's not a tripod. Well, it is kind of like a tripod, but like a smaller version of it. So yeah, I got some of those stuff because that was the next thing that I wanted to talk about. It was just that I wanted to share something with you guys because it's been on my mind. So before I continue on with that thought, I'm going to be using my Maybelline Matte and Poreless Foundation. I am in the color, is it 125? It's the nude beige chair. Okay, I didn't even know that was a color, but I'm using this one. And I switch my foundations literally like every day. I just like to try different stuff, and I feel like sometimes I'm feeling one foundation more than the other. Sometimes you want a matte, sometimes you want like a very glowy foundation. So right now I want something matte because it's so hot outside that I already know I'm going to be super oily, so I want something that's really going to stay on my skin. So I'm using this today. But I do have to say, I do switch out my foundations a lot, but they're only drugstore. So I actually don't own any full coverage foundation or high-end foundation. I only use, not that I only use, but for some reason that's all I have, is like medium coverage foundations, and they're all from the drugstore. So I'm gonna be using my foundation. I usually start with half my face and then keep going. But anyways, so I wanted to share something with you guys, and it's because it truly has been on my mind. I just wanted to say, or I've been thinking to myself, I really need to get to the point. So I am very, very proud of myself, no matter what anyone says. I love the fact that I actually had the courage to post on YouTube. It is very, very hard, especially like to put your life out there, because people can make fun of you, you know, and some stuff might be embarrassing and whatnot, you know, just stuff like that. So I am just very, very proud of myself for posting videos and continuing on with it. I feel myself getting better at videos, because the first couple videos that I posted were like 2 minutes long. And in all honesty, it's because first, yes, there wasn't so much to film. My life isn't so exciting. But second, because I was so picky with the footage I would post. Like, I thought what I did was embarrassing, or I looked ugly, or I don't want people to know this about my life, and just so on, stuff like that. But I've gotten a lot better, because my last vlog was 15 minutes long. So compare it to 2 minutes to 15 minutes. I am so proud of myself, because I am becoming more comfortable. I'm becoming more myself on camera, which I'm super happy about. And I want to continue doing it. I really do. I enjoy doing it, even though it can be really discouraging sometimes. I was looking at my videos, like the first one that I put about 6 months ago, and it's just so embarrassing. But you know what? It's fine, because I mean, as long as some of you guys are watching, that was another thing. I didn't think anyone would watch, but I have some people watching, so that's another thing that I'm super happy about. And thanks, guys, for watching. But it was just something that I was really, really discouraged by, watching my first video a couple months ago, and it's just embarrassing. But you know what? That was my life, or that is my life, and I just have to be happy with it, and I will continue to grow and continue to be a better vlogger, I guess you can say. But thank you guys for watching, by the way. So that was something I wanted to say really quick. So I'm gonna put on my foundation. You know what? I mean, it doesn't match me that bad. I feel like my body is super white, but my face is like a little darker. But we'll make it work. So I'm gonna start off with half my face and then continue on. So this is basically what I do almost on an everyday basis. Sometimes I do give my skin about 2 to 3 days just without any makeup, because sometimes my skin gets irritated, not by the products, but really it's just because I will be wearing makeup constantly, like in 5 days in a row, or even sometimes 3 days in a row. So I sometimes have to give it a couple days to like breathe, but usually I do wear makeup on an everyday basis, and this is what I like to do. I like something very, very natural. I don't like going too out, especially just, again, I want my face to be able to breathe, you know, especially when it's so hot here in LA. I mean, like, I can't wear too much makeup. So we're gonna continue on with this. This half, let me mention a few things. One thing, I did say I like something natural, I like something lightweight, but I do still want something that's going to cover. Let me show you guys what, well, not let me show you guys unless you guys already saw, but let me tell you what I personally deal with. I have redness here. It's gone away over the years, and as I've grown older, it has gone away. But when I was a very little girl, that's something that I was always actually really insecure about, and I hated about myself. It was just that I dealt with so much redness around my nose. That has like almost fully gone away. Around my cheeks, I get super red. So that's something that I want my foundation to be able to cover, and this foundation does do that for me. So I love that to be covered. And around my mouth, I have very like dark areas. I love that to be covered. I don't put my foundation under my eyes because I'm already gonna put concealer, so I don't wanna even put more product under there, because that's probably like my biggest issue is I've tried everything for under eye creasing, and nothing seems to work for me. My under eyes are just crazy dry, and my under eyes just always seem to crease, and it looks like I forgot to put like makeup product under there or something. But I try to make it work. I mean, I always have to touch up throughout the day, but I have been using my Tarte Shape Concealer, and the Better Skin is really good. And these are actually two completely different colors. So see how one is a lot lighter? So this one's darker and this is a lot lighter. And I thought I was liking that like very light under eye, so that's why I got it, but I actually don't like it so much anymore. But this one is a lot like very full coverage. Also with this one, I see people, I mean everyone has their different taste, but I see some people using this one and literally making like a whole triangle, which I don't understand, because I did it with this one and it looked crazy. This is so full coverage. Literally all I need is, I put too much on this side, but it's just a dot. Like this goes such a long way. So also I know people who like finish this, well they can have it forever, but I cannot see myself finishing this because I use so little, because you do need so little of this. So yeah, I'm gonna use that under my eyes. I can't close this. Okay. And we're gonna blend it out with my Eco Tools beauty sponge. You see, look, that's like already, just that dot is like enough for my whole eye. Great. You see, I added a dot and it's still super like crazy full coverage. So I have to blend this, but it won't look as bright after I set it, because my setting powder has a little bit of a tint to it, so it's more of my skin color, which I don't mind. But I put very little, so I'm just gonna keep blending this out. Next, we're gonna go ahead and set my under eyes. I actually have no idea where this is from or something. It just looks like this. And I've had this for maybe over a year now. I honestly use like so very little. You see, just like that. Just enough to make sure it stays in place. And then to set the rest of my face, I use a different powder. And I use the same brand from my foundation. It's the Maybelline Fit Me powder. Again, it's gonna keep me matte, but not crazy matte either, because I love it, because I honestly still feel like I have a glow to my skin. It could be the moisturizer butter bronzer from Physician Formula. I honestly just use this to add just very light color to my face. I don't put too much on it. I don't like contour or anything like that. I just want a little bit extra color on my face. But I do like to bronze up my forehead a little more than I do my cheeks. I probably put too much on there, so we're gonna keep blending. But I do like having a pretty bronze forehead. I used to hate blush, but now I feel like it's an essential. Like I cannot leave the house without adding some blush to my face. The reason I hated it so much before was because, again, like I said, I dealt with so much redness, so I wasn't trying to put that back on my face. But I feel like I add so much color, and it just feels like it's bringing you back to life. Shade, let me see, it's kind of the color of my nails. It's just a single eyeshadow, and I just put this all over my lid. So what I'm gonna do is just, I usually grab my finger, just kind of get some product in there. I know it looks like weird, but so I'm gonna do that to both my eyelids. So you just literally pat some on. You don't even have to do it perfectly. So we see how I only put it a little bit. I'm going to get a blending brush. This is from Real Techniques. And I'm going to blend the shadow all over my lid and in my crease. So that was pretty much what I like to do for my makeup on a daily basis. I hope you guys enjoyed that and like chatting with Mia for a bit. Okay, I am ready to go. I got my outfit on and got my shoes on, got my makeup done, did my hair in less than like 10 minutes. So I'm so happy about that, because she's coming a lot earlier than I thought. And my makeup is sweating off. I'm sure you can tell by my hairline. Like, it's so freaking hot outside, but
We're gonna have fun, guys.
You have to. Do it for me. So we're gonna grab some Starbucks right now. Right, Miholani?
It's all cute and I just came from school looking all muddy.
Because it's so hot today. Oh, girl! I just slapped her with my camera. So we're gonna grab some Starbucks and then head to Ulta. I'll keep the right. Ooh, that double chin though. Okay. What are you gonna order? What are you gonna order? Oh my god, look at her cutest cute. I should have gone with you, dude.
I know.
So basically, there was like a sale at this one place. What's the
Sonic?
Oh, Sonic. Hi, how are you? Oh, my god. Oh, that's so sweet.
Okay, even more.
Oh, oh, you wanna come in here?
Hi. Came to Starbucks.
Hold on.
I wanted a mango black tea lemonade. Like, I was looking so freaking forward to it because that's for sure one of my favorite drinks, and I was so thirsty. They didn't have it. I guess Starbucks isn't selling that anymore. So I got a peach black tea lemonade. I mean, it's good, but it's like kind of like weird tasting. I'm drinking the lemonade because my lipstick. So, but yeah. That's what's going on. Miholani went to go grab her charger and she has like the cutest portable charger. Look how freaking adorable this is. I saw a makeup bag with this design at Target. I wanted it so bad, but it was like $30 for this like small little makeup bag. Come here. Oh, guys, Miholani has a channel too, but she's not posing for a little bit, but she's going back on it. I know.
Ew,
she is.
No, but not looking like this.
So Tat, what is your channel about?
So, honestly, anything specific?
Yeah. I think, no, I'm the same. Honestly, I just decided one day, I don't know about you, but I just decided one day to be like, you know what, I'm gonna post videos. I knew my main thing was gonna be vlogs because, ooh, girl, because I'm not good at makeup, I'm not that good at hair, so I was like, I'm just gonna vlog about my life and share it with you guys. So that's what I've been doing. I posted like somewhat makeup videos, but you know. Miholani does the same too. She just like vlogs and stuff. And she has like the cutest fiance with her and she's just all cute and stuff. Show them your ring. She's engaged too, so.
Wait, there you go. Sorry guys, I just came from school. Oh, you know, I looked for parking for an hour and a half today. I was about to cry. I was crying.
Woo, so the baristas at Starbucks are so nice and gave us two free drinks to try. It is the strawberry acai with coconut milk.
And this
is
raspberry like, syrup.
Oh, yes. Okay. And, and raspberry syrup. But I know this isn't that new, but I've actually never tried it. When I worked there. No?
No, the raspberry one? I've never heard of that.
I don't think that's an actual drink.
No, I know, but like, you know how people create. I've never heard of it.
I don't know, to be honest. I remember sipping it like a little bit when I worked there before. I wasn't the biggest fan of it, but I'm still willing to try it. So, ready, Miholani?
Wait.
Hold on, the lighting. Right here, ready? One,
two, three.
Oh.
I don't like it.
It's actually good. No, I like it.
It's not good.
I like it. Oh, wow. I thought you were going to like it. It's good.
It tastes like I'm drinking perfume or something. Like, you know when you spray something and it gets in your mouth?
I don't think I would order it myself, but I mean, if someone gave it to
me.
I thought I would show you guys what I got at Ulta today. I'm super excited about everything, so this will be like a mini Ulta haul. The first thing that I got was this. And yes, your girl has a mustache, and she has a lot of peach fuzz, so I'm gonna get rid of it with this. I usually wax my mustache, but I don't always have time for that, and I feel like this might be a lot easier. I also heard that by doing this, your foundation will go on a lot smoother, which I'm all for. And then I got a beauty exfoliating sponge, so I'm super excited about that because I usually just use my hands to take off my makeup, so hopefully that goes in like a little deeper. I have two skincare stuff. It is the sleep-in mask, and then it is a scrub that's supposed to help your skin be a lot glowier. Then I have a banana baking powder. I've heard great things about this. A lip scrub, an eyeshadow, and this really, really pretty color. It's basically like the one I used today. This one's like more of a copper color. And then two lipsticks. I have a lip gloss and then a liquid lipstick. They're basically like the same color, but one is a lip gloss and one is a lipstick. So I'm super excited about everything. I might try some on camera right now for the skincare stuff. So I'll see you right now, but my camera's about to die, so